9 o'clock. Let's start with the pledge, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much and welcome to the commissioners' meeting. We'll start with, are there any additions to the agenda? And I believe there are, so.
There is a couple of, yep, so after number three, I need to ask permission to add Joe to the agenda for approval of out-of-state travel. And then after Joe, I'd like to insert Jan, and she's got a resignation, a backfill request, and a leave of absence request. That's it.
Okay. Need a motion?
With those additions, Mr. Chair, I'll make a motion to approve the agenda.
Thank you.
I'll second.
Pat, second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Approve the minutes of the 5/21/24 regular meeting.
Motion to approve.
Thank you, Donnie.
Second.
Ron, any discussion? We'll ask our resident.
No.
Okay, no corrections. Thank you, Jeannie. And any further discussions? Hearing none, I'll call the question. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All the same sign, motion carried. Public comment, I don't believe we have any. So welcome West Central Initiative, Rich and Jill. Nice to see you this morning.
Good morning.
Good morning,
Mr. Chair. Yeah, we got the Rick and Jill shovel this morning, so let's get right
to it.
Thank you for having us. Happy to be here. I'm going to go through the packet. So this tell you what's here, and then Jill afterwards is going to kind of put some more frosting on the cake, if you will. So on the left-hand side in the back is our annual report, Ripples of Good. And back here, you'll see the there's a lot of stories about some of the work we do. And there's I believe there's some things in here about Morris and all of our other communities, our donors. And so that's a good reading for you, and I think we did a nice job with that. Also on the left-hand side is from Deed, a portrait of the county of Stevens County. And this is four pages of your data, four pages double-sided if you're a data person. This is a good reading, or as I sometimes say, I read this and take a nap, but I'm not a data person. So. And just show you some facts and figures so you can have handy for Stevens County. Then in our handout for Stevens County, you can see we have economic impact since 86, since our founding, over 2 million in grants, almost 3 million in loans. And then some of our donor and component donor advised funds, you can see some of that, those figures. Below that are some of our community funds, Chokio, I'm sorry.
Well done.
And who am I, right? Hancock School Fund, Morris Public School Foundation, Library, and so forth. And there's some projects that talk about you and our local board members, Stevens County, Laura and Nancy. On the right-hand side, starting from the back, we have a project called the Rural Democracy Project almost 2 years ago now. And it was in response to some research showing that our communities are, we have 82 communities with 400 some townships in our 9 counties. And some of those were having trouble finding volunteers or people to step up, take office, or join a nonprofit or be on a board, because you got library boards, you got school boards, you got soil water districts, all these opportunities for people to get involved. And to tell you the truth, when I was going around some of the city council meetings, a couple in the region, I did 25 a couple years ago, 25 different city council meetings, and a couple of them I was the youngest one in the room. And so people, we want to say, how do we get people interested to step up? Are they not educated, afraid? Or what's the some of the barriers. So we did a little research with Ben Winchester from the University Extension and talked about some of the stressors on leadership in our counties and communities. And for instance, in this little handout says in Stevens County, well, in Stevens County, 1 in 9 people need to step up and be involved. If you go down to Hennepin, one of the Twin Cities areas, there's 1 in 200 need to be involved, so that it, you know, got 1 in 9 here. So people need to know about getting involved in our government and in our institutions and our nonprofits. Mm-hmm. Loan program, you're very very familiar with the loan program and things we do here with the small enterprise, business, industry, childcare loans. That's our that caters back to the little booklet. I always say I really love this little booklet in the front that talks about our work as a regional development organization. It's a quick read, and it kind of gives you a snapshot of how West Central Initiative went from being just a nonprofit community foundation nonprofit to also wearing the hat of the development organization for the region. And in that first page, there's a map that shows you the state. The Initiative Foundation is a bond, which were founded in the 80s by the McKnight Foundation. And the development organizations on top were the only one that wears both those hats. So, it's a quick read. That's a good information. On the back here, we have we are a nonprofit, 501c3. So we are looking to raise funds for our work. And this Start Ripple campaign, I believe, Mr. Chair, you were at our event here we had here at the Hudson Inn about a month ago or so. And we're continuing having these kind of gatherings to introduce people to our work and what we do. You go out and people say, what's West Central Initiative? And this is kind of the ripple is how do we get more people involved or more people to know about our work? And some of the areas our focus are our children, the Regional Climate Action Roadmap, Thriving Kids, Public Service, so you can look at that Ripple campaign. Finally, next week, June 12th, Wednesday, we have over 200 people coming to your community, or to come to your county, coming to Morris for this West Central 17 Rooms event. Those 200 people, at some point, they're going to divide up into 17 different rooms and talk about different aspects of our lives in this region, be it cities and towns, sustainability, clean water, schools, local government, things of that nature. 17 different areas, and then kind of come together and get some quick action items together, come back, report. That's a day-long event here at the University of Minnesota Morris. Next week, and we have if you want to sign up, you're still eligible to do that too, but I hope maybe see some of you there, and Joe and I will be there. And finally, in the packet, you have our business cards. I put Jill's on top. She's the one. So if you have any problems, you get the top card. If you want to say something nice, you get the card next below it, okay? So that's my spiel.
One point I'd like to compliment you. You spent a lot of time in Morris. You had those three programs out at the Rock.
Right.
I made all three of them and excellent, excellent speakers and programs and a good attendance. I'd like to make this room 17. I'd planned on it, but I've got a meeting in St. Cloud I have to be at because we're doing budgets for Emergency Service Board. But those three programs were excellent. And I think you had great attendance too. So
thank you, Mr. Chair.
Just
we'll have you send someone to your place, okay?
I was all excited about room 17, but I can't do it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm actually one of the room leads. For 17 rooms, yes. Uh-huh. So
I'm kind of looking forward to it. The more I find out about it, it's kind of intriguing in some aspect. Mm-hmm. I'm curious.
Yeah. Well, do you know what time does it actually start?
I should know that.
I haven't found anything yet.
You should get a email confirmation. I think today was what going to send out.
Okay, great.
Some of the data, but starts in the morning.
Great.
And I think we're done about 4 o'clock.
When
happy hour starts.
Happy hour.
On West Central.
Bob, if you get back.
I will.
Anyway,
Thank you.
Ron, last year we talked about that rural democracy, bringing that to like high school students. Has there been any work on that?
We are working with Lakes Country Service Cooperative to try and get their staff involved too. They have those connections with the school districts across our region. And we want to make sure that we're including, I don't know if you were able to attend last year, they had a World Savvy is what it was called. And they bring in high school students and have them think critically about the issues that are affecting us here. And so we're trying to get that, a partnership like that formed again to really get into classrooms.
Yep.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Good.
As Rick said, I'm Jill Amundson. I'm the impact evaluator at West Central Initiative. So I have the boring numbers for you. We are, as Rick said, we're very proud to host your community funds and that list on that sheet. Over the last year and a half, they have distributed over $400,000. And then other funds that WCI has contributed to Stevens County, early childhood is $14,000, early childhood dental $10,000, other discretionary grants $57,500, and then the Deed Main Street revitalization work was $896,000 over the last year and a half. And our board had asked that per person, so I just happened to have the number per capita if you were interested in Stevens County. If you looked at grants and where they said they would serve, if they included Stevens County, that would be $158 per person in Stevens County. If you look at it by address, it if the nonprofit was within Stevens County, that's $83 per person over the last 5 years.
Very good.
And then we also bring notes from our staff. They wanted to send thank you for your participation with the St. Ralston School in Morris. Mr. Chair, a special thank you for the area transportation partnership work you're doing.
Thank you.
And then 17 rooms we mentioned. Oh, and Stevens, we're working with the Stevens County HRA. We gave them part of their housing study, just the data portion that we were able to fund through our economic development grant that we received. So we provided that data to them. I'm hoping that they were able to complete the study with site assessments. But we continue to work with them in hopes of getting some more funds that direction.
You've been bigger in our community and our county lately, so I really appreciate that. So
we appreciate the partnerships and invitations. It's been a lovely partnership.
That's been great. Your support. So any questions, anything on top of mind? We have any, we're always available. Just always like coffee.
Common
but we'll see. We'll see you at the 17 rooms.
Yeah, wonderful.
Appreciate your time and support.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for coming.
Yes, thank you, Amazon. Thank you.
And we'll move on to Bill.
Well, after our May 15th county board work session, I forwarded the county draft floodplain ordinance to the DNR for their review and conditional approval. On May 21st, I received notice that the conditional approval was approved, or they approved it as a conditional approval with one small change. And that was simply a letter change in the community map number from B to A. So that change has been made in the ordinance that has been attached and the request. The next step is for the county to hold a public hearing on the draft updated ordinance. It's my intent ordinance could be set for July 2nd at a county board meeting. That would allow enough time to get the notice in the newspaper and provide written notice to the cities and townships in the county of the updated ordinance hearing. And as you're all aware, this ordinance has to be adopted by the county by September 12th, 2024, in order for the county to maintain their national flood insurance program status. So my request is to schedule that hearing for July.
And that's a board day, correct? So it'll be part of our board meeting. So that should work out. So anybody have?
We need a motion for that or?
Do you need a motion or should we?
Well, just motion to set it for the 2nd at 9:30 a.m. or as soon as the.
So moved.
Thank you. First by Donnie and a second by Jeannie. Mm-hmm. Any discussion? Call the question. All in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Bill.
So I don't, Joe, you want to go with your out-of-state travel, I get it.
Oh, sure. 1 second here.
That's okay. I'm going to hand this out here. You guys can take a minute to read it. Just so you guys remember that county policy requires the board to approve all out-of-state travel outside of, like, the neighboring communities. We have a policy that allows for, like, travels like Fargo and Grand Forks and places like that, border communities, but anything out-of-state has to be board approved. So that's why it's asked to be put in front of you today. And when Joel's ready, he can give a little bit of background on the travel if you read through that there.
Yep.
Okay, so this is travel that the County Attorney Association, MCAA, has a scholarship that they fund. We've applied and they've agreed to fund travel for Tegan to go to, this will be in Albany, New York, go to a symposium on a prosecution and investigation as it relates to child abuse, specifically medical evidence, things of that nature. So we think it's a good training. It's co-sponsored by the Zero Abuse Project, which is Minnesota based. We think it's sort of responsive to our needs. Unfortunately, we only learned about scholarship opportunity was only announced, I think, last week. So sort of short notice, but they got back to us right away when we applied. We anticipate around $1,800 in costs and indicate they can cover it all. So we don't really think there'll be any, and certainly not very much county expense to this travel.
Need a motion for that?
I have a question. When are the dates of this travel?
June 14th.
Yes.
Oh, I see. Okay, June. Okay, well, that's coming up. Okay. I'll also move to approve this out-of-state travel as requested.
Thank you.
Second
by Jeannie. Any further discussion? Not, I'll call the question. All in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Have a good trip.
Yep. Hey, the next, I think we had a Jan.
Yeah.
If you guys are ready.
Just going to do a handout. This does have some help information on there. If you could take a moment to read that before I ask for the approval, and then I'll collect the letter after we're done.
Thank you.
Need a copy?
Okay. Well, yeah, I should not. Sounds like medical stuff.
Yeah.
Any discussion on this or?
So the policy 7.16 leave of absence, it gives the department head the right to approve unpaid leave up to 7 calendar days, and then anything over 7 calendar days must be approved by the county board. There's so the leave would be unpaid. It would not be benefit eligible. There'd be no PERA. The individual's date of anniversary would change for purposes of step increase to account for that unpaid leave. The department has is very supportive of this request, very much wants this person to be able to come back after this is done with. If you didn't have any other...
I believe, too, he was able to find some folks from...
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Yes. He reached out to 3 individuals who had previously been helping out as their time, and all 3 of them had indicated that they could help cover some shifts. So we do have that as an option, and they've been managing so far without this person because... she's been on an medical leave of absence for the past 12 weeks.
Yeah, I think we should reach out to this individual and extend this or award this absence. And we have trouble finding good dispatchers.
Yes,
and,
yes.
And we have to work.
Experience.
Yeah, work at this to get this.
Yeah, right. I agree.
So I guess I'd be looking for a motion to extend this leave of absence to.
Okay. I'll make that motion. Mm-hmm.
September 16th is kind of a date that's been pushed out there. It could be sooner than that.
Sure.
That would be
how things go. Maybe things will make a
fundraiser set up or anything like that.
Not that I'm aware of, not through the county.
So I had a motion by Pat.
Second
by Jeannie. Any further discussion? Hearing none, I'll call the question. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
She needs these letters back.
Oh, okay. Sure. Sorry.
Oh, I gave it 2 pieces.
There you go.
There you go.
That's my hand.
Yep. Thank you. And unfortunately, I've requested... accept the resignation of Mackenzie Roloff. She's a records manager in the Sheriff's Department, has been here just under 10 years. That would be effective June 14th. Give it 2 weeks notice.
Need a motion to accept that?
I'll make that motion.
Thank you, huh? Second by Donnie. Any further discussion? In favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
And then a motion to approve a backfill of the position.
Jeannie, thank you.
I'll second.
Pat, motion to backfill. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Is she looking for another position?
Yes. She has a realtor's license.
Yeah.
She said she's doing very well with that. That and some kind of part-time work.
Mm-hmm. Becky's ready. We'll move on to Becky.
I think I have the warrants in there first. If you have any questions on any of
those warrants are duplicate.
Huh?
Some of the 516 warrants are duplicate. We had them last time.
Oh, we had them ready right before and they went with the package.
Right.
Yeah.
I didn't even think about that.
Yeah. Yes.
I did add them at the last time.
Yeah. I had a question on page 523, page 3. PACE Clean Energy Week.
Yep.
Did we have someone apply for that?
We had 2 people apply for it. One of them was the ethanol plant, and the other one was Denco, and the other one was Hudson. And Hudson didn't go all the way through with it. They seeked financing elsewhere. If that's the Denco one.
Okay.
That's just an in out.
Yeah, it's been a long time since that.
He was here, yeah.
That they were here to ask.
Yeah, it's a long payback.
Right? Yeah.
Yep.
Any other questions? If not, we'll move on to the service agreement for approval.
Okay. Out of here. The service agreement is between us and Shannon Asmus. The request is to authorize that to help fill in some training that myself and staff couldn't provide to Shannon's, to Katie. Shannon's willing to come in before hours, after hours, or kind of over lunchtime. I put 60 hours before on or before September 1st. I don't think we'll do 60 hours. I think it'll be 20, 15 or less, something like that, because Cherry and Lori were able to do a lot of training that of duties that they were filling in, but there's a few month-end reconciliation things and stuff like that. We've identified a short list, less than 5 things we'd like Shannon to come in and train on. So she's willing to do that. Her employer is willing to grant her some flexibility to do that. So I would like to ask for the board's approval. It's $40 an hour. It's paid as a contractor because she's specifying the time and place of her work, not to exceed 60 hours and not to go past September 1st. So looking for a motion for approval. Any questions?
Thank you. Got a motion?
I'll make that motion to approve.
No, Donnie made the motion.
Oh, Donnie did. I'll second then.
Okay, got a motion and a second now. Do you have any discussion? I'm thankful that she will do this because the line we're in, I think it's great to have somebody with her knowledge and to help out. Any other discussion? Hearing none, I'll call the question. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Okay, I'm just everybody today. I got everybody's hats. Todd is at a training today, so I'm going to ask for disposal of an asset for the County Highway Department. He'll actually present his engineer's report at the second meeting this month in June. It's a training that he was at today, so he felt like it was important to go to that. Not that it wasn't important to be here, but his things could wait till the second meeting. So with the exception of this, he'd like to request the board's approval to dispose of unit number 85, which is the 2005 Freightliner tandem truck. It's was scheduled to be traded in on a truck purchase, on the 2022 truck purchase that we are just getting, that's going to be delivered in August. And he just noted because of the increased equipment prices, he feels that we could do better than the $25,000 trade-in that was guaranteed as a part of this previous deal. So he'd like to try it on bid with a reserve of $25,000 just to guarantee we get that base amount. And so he'd like your approval now to start advertising that to see if we could get rid of it before we'd have to trade it in August. So looking for the board to approve disposal of an asset, unit number 85, 2005 Freightliner tandem truck on the mid-bid auction with a reserve of $25,000.
So will they adjust the price of the new truck because we're not trading in? I mean, sometimes the prices are different if you don't trade in. So
right. Well, so the total purchase price is the same.
Oh, okay.
It would just be less than $25,000. And he told the salesman he's going to try to sell it privately just or on auction because of how much the prices have changed since we got that quote for the trade-in.
Yeah, is there a motion?
I'll make that motion.
Thank you, Ron.
I'll second.
Pat, second. Any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
We'll move into closed session. Under the statute, Minnesota Statute 13D.05 sub 3B. I need a motion for that.
So
Jeannie?
I'll second.
On second, anybody that shouldn't be here? Thank you, ladies. Appreciate it.
Okay, stop. Let me just wait till.
Hi, thanks for waiting.
Anytime. I've got a couple of things on the agenda for the board to consider. The first thing I would like is authority from the board to authorize a separation agreement between Stevens County and the AFSCME Council 65 and Robert Schneider, effective after his 15-day rescission period has expired.
Mr. Chair, I will make that motion.
Thank you.
I'll second.
Donnie seconds it. Any further discussion? Hearing none, I'll call the question. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you, Beth. And in consideration of that separation agreement, once that is final, I will leave an open position. Today, I'd like to seek the board's approval for advertisement to fill a highway maintenance worker. I'm not asking for the authority to hire right now. I'm just asking for the authority to start that advertisement. We'd come back with a name and a hire date as soon as that process is complete, and we know that that period's expired. So I would be looking for authority to backfill, or not backfill, but to authorize a hire of a highway maintenance worker.
Need a motion?
Mr. Chair, I so move.
Thank you, Pat.
I'll second it.
Donnie seconds. Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you very much. Appreciate that. I know you're going to go on to commissioner's reports, and then we'll do meetings afterwards. So just let's talk about the meetings, because it's kind of a busy tune after you guys are done. Sure. So.
Commission reports?
Prime West had their Supreme Court hearing yesterday morning, and Jim said it went very well. When the Supreme Court justices started asking questions to the opposing counsel, they didn't have the answers, so it went very well.
CPT, we're going to have a Zoom meeting with two roofers. We got to put a new roof on the building we bought. Further down the line, we're going to look at doing a little remodeling on this half that we bought from Morris Electronics. I guess that's about it. Go ahead.
I participated in a Zoom meeting with West Central Initiative on training. I'm going to be a room lead for the 17 rooms coming up next week. Also, I had a governing board meeting at Fergus Falls with Viking Library. And on May 23rd, attended the AMC's Home Run Leadership Workshop. That was very interesting. I found that Dr. Dave Webb was the person who led the group, teaching his guide to training on collaborative team decision making, consensus building, and inclusive team participation. Workshop involved actual hands-on teaching as each team participated in that, and we learned a lot about Dr. Webb's simple five-step science of what he calls IROD, like I-R-O-D, and that is whenever we're working with problem solving, we need to first gather the information and then wait for the reactions and then the options, consider options that might be available, and then making decisions. And he calls that IROD, I-R-O-D. So he said, as once we've learned that and our skills continue to grow, he said, so will our confidence and its power to move people and organizations forward. So needless to say, I found it very valuable. I also participated in a virtual listening meeting with the Department of Revenue with Becky and Bob last week. That's it.
I have none. I haven't had any meetings since our last board meeting.
I love the report on.
I will make a motion to adjourn.
Second. Oh, tie for the second. You have to put them both down. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, same sign, motion carried.